WordPress is the most popular content management system in the world. In the entire universe of websites, WordPress CMS, it's the biggest. I'm talking about 63% of the entire market share. It is huge. And also, it's an open source technology. And because of that, it's susceptible to so many vulnerabilities. There are always vulnerabilities on WordPress, which makes it the perfect scenario for hackers to attack. Now, as a pen tester and ethical hacker in the red team, you want to have a tool that can check for vulnerabilities and you can use to penetrate WordPress websites. And what is the best tool? WP Scan. WP Scan is an amazing tool, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use it. From the beginning to the end, you'll be equipped with the right tool to conduct reconnaissance and penetration testing on WordPress applications as part of your cybersecurity arsenal. So go get your coffee, get ready, and let's get going. This video is intended for educational purposes only. The techniques and tools demonstrated are to be used in a legal and ethical manner. Misuse of this information can result in legal consequences, so ensure you have explicit authorization before applying these methods. All right, so the first thing I'm doing is just powering up my terminal in here. I have two tabs open. One that is my knowledge base articles, and the other one is going to be my damn vulnerable WordPress applications. So there are two requirements for running WP Scan. The first one is Docker. So you have to have Docker installed. If you don't have Docker installed yet, don't worry about it. I have a video on how to install Docker on Kali Linux right below on the links. The second thing that we need is going to be the damn vulnerable WordPress application, which it's a Docker container that I also have down in the link if you don't know how to install it. All right, so I'm here in my Docker container, right? As you can see, so I'm going to start Docker compose and then up minus D. So now if I go to localhost 31337, then you'll see that this is my vulnerable WordPress. Now, if you want to install the vulnerable WordPress, just go to my GitHub in here and you will see it right on my repositories. So here it is. This is the damn vulnerable WordPress application, right? So we have that done. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my KBS, so my knowledge base articles, and then type in code dot and. So I can initiate Visual Studio Code. I have a whole bunch of stuff here. So I have tools and readmes about pretty much a lot of stuff for mobile, cloud, networking, and all of that stuff. So we are looking here for WP Scan. So this is WP Scan. Now let me just kill this. And so this is WP Scan. Let me just do a preview on Markdown. There you go. WP Scan. This tool is for WordPress security scanning and vulnerability assessments. So it's great to be able to test vulnerable WordPress applications, and it's designed for identifying security weaknesses on WordPress websites. It has a lot of capabilities too. So the first one is it checks for WordPress version, and especially the vulnerable WordPress versions. It looks for vulnerable plugins, vulnerable themes. It does username enumeration, and it also does password brute forcing for WordPress. So that's really good. I'm going to show you how to do that exactly as well in this video. So stay here, stay tuned to my video. It checks for WP config files. It does error log finding. It does media file enumeration. Vulnerable TimThumbs is an PHP library that it helps you with cropping images, and that's very vulnerable. It does full path disclosure as well as upload directory listing, and it checks for backup. So these are all the capabilities of WP Scan. Now let's look at the argument or the different switches that you can put through on WP Scan. The first one is obviously WP Scan. So if I go into my terminal here and I do WP Scan help, then you'll see all the information about WP Scan. So these are the different arguments. Let me just make this a little smaller for you so you can see. And let's do it again. So these are all the switches that you can do on WP Scan. Just make it bigger now. Now, if I put TLDR WP Scan, then it gives you kind of like the rundown on the main things that you can do. WP Scan update, that's the first one. So let's do just that, WP Scan update, and it's checking the database there, and the update is complete. So that's the first thing you gotta do. Then the second one is your URL. This is where you put the URL, right? So in my case, I do localhost colon 31337, but this could be any website, of course, a website that you're going to be pen testing. Then we have the dash EU. So this is enumeration of users. Now you can actually give it a pass
path to usernames, so a library of usernames that you want to check, but WPScan does that for you automatically. Then you can do passwords, right? So for brute forcing, and then you can identify a file that you want to use. In this case, I'm going to use the rocku.txt file on my word list. Then you can enumerate plugins, and you can do a few things with enumeration of plugins. The first one is all plugins, so AP, and the second one would be VP, which is vulnerable plugins. You can also do plugin detection aggressive. So this is where WPScan does a really good job, very aggressively trying to find those vulnerable plugins for you. Enumeration of themes, enumeration of theme thumbs, and then you can force WP content directories. So sometimes when you are using security tools, you can change the WP content directory for a WordPress application, so you can define it in here. Usually it is WP content. Same with the WP plugins directory, you can force detection of those. Then you have threats, the different threats that you can throw in the tool. This is how many threats at a time the tool is going to be using. This really has to do with your machine. So if you have really low RAM, you know, you should do like 5 to 10 threats. If you have a really good machine, then you just do, we can do 100 threats, so it's faster. Then this is very important, your API token. Now, let me just go into the WPScan website and I'm going to log into WPScan. So log in. And this is your token. You have to use your token or else the tool is going to be very limited for you. So I really recommend you to use the token. In my case, I have this token. I've changed this token so you don't use my token. Get your own token and you can use it as well. Then we have Stealthy. Now Stealthy, it does a few things like random user plus a whole bunch of other things like anonymity if you want to conceal your identity as much as possible. But then you can also use random user agents, for example, Opera or Firefox or Chromium, a mobile random user or agent. Then we have V for verbose, so if you want to get more information from it. And then you have force. If you have, for example, a security plugin that hides the WordPress application, then forcing the WP scan is really good because then you're telling, yes, this is a WordPress application, please scan it, right? So force is good. Then you can do a proxy, and this is really cool, and I'll show you how to do that. So for example, using Burp Suite. So I'm going to launch Burp Suite in here. Next, start Burp Suite. Now on Burp Suite, if I go to proxies and then I do proxy settings, you'll see that my interface is 127.0.0.1:8080. So this is my interface. So what I'm trying to say here is that when you do a proxy, all the data is going to be proxied through this IP address, which means that your Burp Suite is going to capture all the data. And that's what you want, right? You want to be able to read a lot of the data as well. Again, you can use WPScan in conjunction with something like Burp Suite or Zap. For example, that's another tool that you can use. And then there's a detection mode mixed. So you can do both. You can do a passive and an aggressive detection on enumerating different things like your plugins, for example. Now, this is a bug that I found on the WPScan, and this is why I'm going to use the mixed in the code, as you will be able to see. And at the very end, we have the stud out exporting into whatever file you want. So having said that, then this is some of the code that I have, and I like putting the code like this, right? So I don't like making one entire string. I like dividing the code into different chunks so I can see exactly what I'm doing. And that's what you got to do because it gets really messy. And you know it gets messy when you're doing end mapping or you're using so many tools on the terminal and you have to put them on one line. It's better that you work on them. For example, I use Visual Studio to be able to do all of this stuff, right, for me. So before I throw in the tool, because then it makes it easier. You don't have to change things around in the terminal, right? So it's much easier to do this. So let's just do that, right? So I'm going to go back to my DVWP, and then I'm just going to paste this code in here. And what I'm doing in here is basically doing WPScan, the URL, as we saw it over here. So this one in here, right? So localhost 31337. I'm going to do the passwords. Now the passwords are right in here. So if I go... let me just copy this CD and I'll go into my word list. So if I click enter here and do LS, then I'm going to be using this work list for trying to brute force into the application. So then I'm going to do all plugins. So I'm going to enumerate all plugins, plugins detection aggressive. I'm going to enumerate all themes. I'm going to enumerate all theme thumbs, giving it the WP content directory as well as the plugins directory. I made a mistake in here, as you can see in threats. So in threats, I'm supposed to put two dashes in here. And you can see, this is why I do it like this, because then you can see the mistakes that you're making, right? So this is perfect. There, two dashes. And then now everything is good in here. I'm going to do 20 API token, then my stealthy. I'm going to do verbose and I'm going to force it. And at the very end, I'm going to do proxy. And this is the bug that I found that I'm actually fixing it because it wasn't reading my plugins for some reason. So I threw in a detection mode mixed and enumerate AP. So having said that, then all I have to do is just click on enter. okay, let's do this again. Do not have to have the dashes. So I apologize for that. So let's just do this again without the dashes. The quirks of the tools when you're using them, and then threads 20, let's run it. Perfect. So it already started, as you can see, and it's starting to get a lot of the information. So yeah, that's amazing. Now it's enumerating all the plugins via aggressive methods. Now this is going to take a while because I'm putting everything. I'm enumerating the plugins and enumerating users and doing brute force. And that's why you need to know the arguments. You need to know how to use the tool properly to be able to do a good scan and a good penetration test afterward. I'm going to fast forward this video a little bit so we can see exactly the rest of the stuff. Hey guys, this is Dan Duran, and I hope you're liking this video. And if you do, please smash that subscribe button. Make sure you like this video and put any comments down below, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible, just like a phone. So before I run the tool, what I usually do is I do a stutout into wpscan.txt so I can record all the results. So if I do nano wpscan.txt, then this is the report. So the first thing that it did, I mean, it did a lot of findings in terms of the headers, the XML RPC, which is enabled, and it's a vector point for attacks. Check the README, the cron is enabled, WP cron, the version as 5.3, insecure, released in 2019. It identified a whole whack of vulnerabilities, authenticating proper access control on the REST API, and a whole bunch of other ones that I'm not going to mention here. I'm only going to mention a few that are very important. So cross-site scripting we see here, disclosure of password protected pages, authenticated password protected pages, object injection, SQL injection via WP query. And this one is important. This one is kind of one of the big ones. And then looking for this information on the web, then you can see here, there is a WP query SQL injection payload that we can use. As you can see, this is doing a post on the WP admin Ajax, right? So we can use Burp Suite for this payload. And then I saw another one here that is very important. It is the remote code execution. So an authenticated remote code execution that we can do on the server. And here's the Python script for doing the payload, right? So we'll see that vulnerability in a second here. There's a whole bunch of them that you can actually attack in your penetration testing. And then if I go down a bit more, then we will see here the use of 2020 as the main theme. And it also shows us outdated. And then it starts to enumerate all the plugins via aggressive method and then passive method because I put the next. Akismet, and here are some vulnerabilities identified with the plugins, IWP client, infinite WP client, social warfare. There's a lot of things that you can actually attack on this damn vulnerable WordPress Docker application. WP advanced search, WP file upload, enumerating user via passive and aggressive, and it found admin as a user. And you can see this, it found that user in there. It performed a password attack and then it was successful. The username is admin. The password is admin. If I go here, then I can log in with admin. And there you go. And then the final check on when it was done, and then as well as how long it took and all of that stuff. One of the nice things is that WP scan also gives you all the links that you can check out. So for example, I'm going to check out a few of these so you can see the vulnerabilities in here. So that's from WP scan, but also the MITRE framework, IP Tanis. So let's check this one out. There you go. Plugins track WordPress.com. But the main thing is that if I look for this on the web, I might find some payloads that I can use for this vulnerability. Then you can see ExploitDB, for example. And then if I go here, then I'll be able to see what you have to do to get the POC or the proof of concept. This is how you do the exploitation afterward. Well, this tutorial was great. And if you like this content, make sure you subscribe, make sure you put your comments down below, and I'll see you in the next time.